Dysfunctional Disc Golf. I'm Zach. This is Joe. We're out here at St. Francis Disc Golf Course in Orangeville, and we're getting ready to play an Ironman scratch match round. Just trying to keep it light and casual. Should be a fun day. Let's get it started.
Hole one, St. Francis. We have a 385, almost straight out of the tunnel with a slight fade to the right. You just want to get it through the gut and hope you don't hit anything. And here we go.
Throw my rhythm, hopefully flat, up the gut, get a little bit of turn at the end. That'll be a long putt.
Hole two, St. Francis, plays about 245, I believe. Yes, it does. It is straight through this gap with a slight fade left. So there's two options. You can flip high and out or shoot the straight gap, which with the inertia, I will try to shoot the straight gap. Lucky tree kick, but we take those.
I'm gonna throw my TSA Votum, try to do a little hyzer flip forehand, see how it goes. Got caught up. Hole three, 270 feet. Go out straight, cut into the right around those pine trees. Throw in the paradox, backhand turnover.
Love.
Hole four, about 270 feet. Basket is straight up the gut, kind of a tight gap. So you have a couple options. You can throw the big hyzer out and around, or you can just try to run it straight up the middle.
Try a proxy upshot.
Okay.
Hole five. Oh, I'd say 300 feet. You can take this straight gap or the outside turnover or a flick. Hey, fairway!
Hole six, about 220 feet, straight up the gut, cuts right at the end. Try forehand hyzer flip with the TSA bottom. Little long.
Hole seven, it'll be about 275. You can take this straight little turnover shot to the left, or take the safe right, skip flare in.
Oh, that stayed clean.
Hole eight, about 265, it's straight out the gap and then a slight left.
A little short.
I lifted it. R.
Hole nine, about 250, right back in the tree line. Kind of have to throw off the corner of the tee pad and miss the scary gap. Might have a look at it.
But it's in there. Ooh. Glitch is awesome. Hole 10, about 375.
just above the little sand pit. Very hard hole. You really just want to go for par.
I'll take that.
That'll be a tricky par. Tricky, tricky.
Bogey!
Hole 11, about 205, 210 feet to the basket.
Go with my OTB open R2 Eclipse glitch. Almost.
I will be throwing a proxy.
Light turn shot.
Hole 12, about 200 feet, straight up this tunnel, and right where the trees start to break open a little bit, hard left. Oh, that's real deep. That hit nothing.
Don't do it like that. Squeaky.
Hole 13, got about a 300-foot tunnel shot, just straight up the gut. Go fission wave, try a little hyzer flip. Oh, it slipped out of my hand. Shark time.
Tree hunting. That's all right. Oh, floated over the top.
Hole 14, got about 190 feet. There's not a lot of gap. Really, the only one is straight up the middle.
Par. Hole 15, about 300 feet, 310, straight out the gap. You just want something safely up the middle.
Hole 16, about 300 feet, dead straight.
Hole 17, about 190 feet.
Man, that dropped.
There's a slight headwind in there, so I'm gonna stable up using Envy. Doing fine until that tree, but it's still fine. Par.
Hole 18, 215 feet, straight out the gap, fade a little left at the end.
Final hole is a good plan. I'm at 15, Zach is at 22. I'm gonna have to ace this thing. I'm gonna try to do it with this Benny James. All right. No ace, but it will be a birdie to make me feel better on my last hole.
Good putt.
Yeah.